And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind on
the
RPG Check.
Have you ever chased a skirt wizard, or do you merely hide behind them?
Don't pawn your personal problems off on me.
They will use you, cast you off when it suits them, never speak another word to you.
Maybe they just don't answer to fiery whore.
Perfect. Oh, perfect. Anyway, what? What was I saying? I was kind of distracted here. We're here in the First Fires District of Defiance Bay, about to enter Crucible Keep to deal with the knights, and we do have a quest to do in here, which involves, yeah, you can read about that. Osric was kicked out by a knight named Penhelm we're looking for. They took his breastplate. It's a family heirloom. Where to retrieve the breastplate. Breastplate. And prove Penhelm's forgery for this document from Dunry Dorrell. It would be somewhere in Crucible Keep in First Fires. Unlikely to return the heirloom willingly. Well, if we can prove his forgery, he'll do it. Because I'm not going to fight the guy and all the Crucible Knights. But of course, we're going to look around and stuff before we do much, probably. Unless we come across this Penfold or whatever the hell his name is right away. Oh, I hate that. I hate that. We are over here. Thank you, game. Justiciar Aldemar. What business brings you to the keep? Aldemar gives you an appraising eye. Judging by the scars in his face, he's lucky to be able to do that much. Every day we get more from the hinterlands pouring into Defiance Bay. Keeps us busy on the watch, it does. You look like you've recently arrived yourself. Who are you? A soldier of the Crucible Knights, and proud of it. I help keep everything running at the keeps so that Commander Cliver can focus on more important matters. Looking for something? Or just knocking the dirt off your boots? Yes, all over your nice rug. I don't like the Crucible Knights very much. I'm really going by secondhand knowledge, but, you know, I'll try to keep my opinions kind of malleable, so to speak. What goes on in Crucible Keep? This is the headquarters of the Crucible Knights, so it's where we store arms and armor, as well as many of our soldiers' bunk. Commander Cliver's in the back, making plans, as usual. He scratches a scarred cheek. You'll find the forge at the west end of the building, along with our master smith, Dunstan. There's also a shrine to the golem, if you're the praying type. Tell me about the Crucible Knights. We're the defenders of Defiance Bay. We're not exactly a formal knighthood, but don't tell Commander Cliver I said that. He grins. We were the first organized militia to oppose Adirin rule, and today we're the largest force in the city. Our soldiers undergo years of combat training, and our officers are required to have their souls read by that critter out in Dunry Dorrell. What's this about Dunry Dorrell? Just a requirement of the Crucible Knights, so the higher-ups know there's nothing messy built in your soul's past. Aldemar widens his stance. Keeping the ranks pure is fine with me. I just wish they were more careful in hiring their ciphers. What's wrong with their ciphers? He shifts his weight and glances at the empty halls. They're mostly Orlans. I'm sure they're talented enough, but you just can't trust them. Hostility's in their nature, and they've learned to hide it over the years. He frowns and crosses his arms. All I'm saying is they should at least be supervised by other folk. That's reasonable enough, isn't it? If people treated them better, you wouldn't have to worry about them being so hostile. Aldemar shrugs. I'm just speaking the truth. Nowadays, it seems that's the biggest crime of all. Yeah, that's all for you. He's a bigot. Plain and simple. Dunstan, yes. These guys have anything new to say? I don't know. Yeah. We're the greatest fighting force in all the Deerwood. Yeah, yeah, boast. Let's go through here. This is the forge, I'm guessing? Yeah. Anyone in here?
Margrin's fire casts light in dark
places. We can't get those camping supplies yet.
Places.
I doubt I'll remember they're there. I mean, I'm not gonna sleep in here.
Light, flame, and sound. A simple test.
Peridot. I don't believe we've seen peridot yet. Found almost exclusively in a pale green color, peridot is a glassy stone that is easy to find, but difficult to find in specimens of gem-worthy quality. I take. These guys had their backs turned. Tongues of flame lick at the forge, hissing with smoke as hot as a dragon's breath. Novitiate. We defended Defiance Bay back in Duke Hadrick's day. Here's this Dunstan guy.
If this is about the breastplates, I already told Cleaver they won't be repaired till next week.
The dwarf bustles between a sweltering forge, fire, and a work table. He wipes one muscle-knotted arm across his brow. We'll get to this. What do you do here?
I'm a forge master. I'm a master smith for the Crucible Knights. But the way I see it, I'm also keeping up with our old traditions. The first members of our order were smiths. Nowadays, most everyone's a professional soldier. I suppose it's to be expected, but I think it's important we keep up with our roots, too.
Something else on your mind? I always approve when there's voice acting, means I don't have to read endless stuff. I do enjoy it, but, you know, we need more voice acting in this game. A little bit more, anyway. Tell me about the knights.
We were all smiths back in Hodrit's day. Though I'm about the only one here who still gets his hands dirty.
He laughs.
We're a fearsome fighting force. Though these days, I think Cleaver takes more pride in our parade formations.
Okay, so it's Cleaver, not Cliver. He thinks himself a progressive man, but he's obsessed with soul lineages and connections to the Deerwood's heroes of old. He picks up his hammer again. Other than Dunreed Row, who really knows about any of that, though? So we'll show him the pieces of the Blade of the Endless Pass. I know we need to find all of them. Of course, I'm not going to pass up the chance to see what he says about this. I found several fragments of an ancient sword. Do you think you can repair it? Dunstan gives a low whistle. That's a fine blade indeed. He holds one fragment in his rough hands. Looks a Deerin. Special made. Must have been a commission for a champion of some sort. He hands the shard back to you. A sword of this caliber would have had a specially designed hilt, too. It would be a shame to graft anything else onto it, and besides, it'll balance best with all the original pieces. You find the rest of it, and I'll forge it for you. Thanks. Hardies, hammers, fullers, and punch tools hang from the wall. They feel heavy and sturdy, but their flame-darkened surfaces testify to frequent use. Alright, that's a huge hallway. Let's go through here. Oh, there's that Penhelm guy. Let's just look around the rest of this room first. The blades are razor sharp. The Knight of the Crucible carries himself, or herself, with a solemn demeanor. We've got all kinds of goodies. Goodies over there. Halt, Penhelm! I would have words with thee. The young novitiate's armor is recently shined, and his hair is clean and neatly combed. It's hard to believe he's ever seen battle, or that the scarred antique breastplate he wears could possibly be his. He says, are you looking for something? Tell me about the Knights of the Crucible. We're the primary defenders of Defiance Bay. The Order's founders were the first to rally for Deerwood and independence. He waves his hand. Of course, that's ancient history now. Now we're the most prestigious company of soldiers in the Deerwood. It's a glorious line of work. He scrunches up his nose. If you can forget about the barracks, that is. Was there anything else? How does one become a knight? We don't just take anyone. Our members share soul legacies with the very men and women who defended this land a century and a half ago. He shifts his weight and coughs. Anyhow, Commander Cleaver is responsible for initiations, but he rarely accepts foreigners. Does the name Osric sound familiar? Sniffs. If you've got any self-respect, you won't associate with him, or with any of his new friends at the Expedition Hall, for that matter. Scamps and delinquents, the lot of them. What's the story between you two? Osric has always held some controversial opinions, but they went overlooked for the longest time because his family has such an extensive history of service in the Crucible Knights. He frowns and crosses his arms. He finally went too far. He had the gall to suggest that we had strayed too far from our roots, that some of our officers were beginning to resemble Adir nobility. He rubs a spot on his bracer with a silk handkerchief. Yeah, with a silk handkerchief. He would have us all wear rough spun and fight with forge hammers. I merely reported his statements. That history made the knights what they are now. You can't just cast it aside. We've outgrown that past. He waves a shining gauntlet. Sometimes you need to move on. Sagani frowns. Outgrown it like an old sealskin coat? You adapt with the time, sure, but that's a bit naive. I guess I'm choosing I don't see the problem? He sputters. People change. Organizations change. The Crucible Knights began as a militia of blacksmiths, and Dunstan's one of the only officers who can wield a hammer these days. We're professional soldiers. Isn't that who you want defending a city? Besides, a novitiate has no business maligning his superiors. I don't have an option to leave. Oh, okay. Oh, we were missing an option there. I was like, I don't want to say the other thing. It makes me look a hypocrite just for saying the first thing. Is that his breastplate you're wearing? It was. He looks down and admires it. It became property of the Crucible Knights when he was discharged. Now it's mine. And it's not for sale. That's what you're wondering. Not every day you find armor that was used in the rebellion. He says your affidavit is a forgery. Just what would he know about that? It's perfectly convenient for him to cast aspersions, what with his pedigree and the knights. He folds his arms. He blinks at you. It's a lie, of course. Enough about Osric. On that we can agree. Farewell. Alright, what do we have to say here? Penhelm doesn't agree to be keen on parting with Osric's armor, which he is presently wearing. More leverage is required. Alright, supposedly we can find this forgery, this affidavit. And his soul, supposedly, is not free of Adirian influence. And that thing was forged, so we'll find it somewhere here, supposedly. Okay, so we've been here, went through here. This looks like some kind of training ground. We'll be back.
Time to see and not be seen.
A simple test.
Get experience every time. Even though I don't want this stuff. I'm surprised we can't open this one. What's wrong with this one? It's odd.
A simple test.
Now, I wonder if... Is he the only one getting experience for this? We'll take that money.
I can do that.
We'll take that money. We'll just leave all the various, you know, cheap armor and weapons. I find it really kind of lame to be gathering such stuff and selling it all. I mean, of course we could do it, but...
I can do that.
338 copper here. And yeah, we'll leave the club. Oh, so it shows blue because we didn't take everything. Thick grime cakes the bottom of the tub. The towel hanging from the side gives off an awful stench. Look. Hey, hey, plenty of stuff to be had here.
Slow and silent.
A scroll of prayer against infirmity. Infirmity, yeah. Fortifies the health of allies in the area of effect, granting a bonus against attacks with sickened or weakened afflictions, and reducing the duration of any such afflictions currently on a target. Pretty awesome. 22 golden dukes. And Edict of Arrest. This edict calls for the arrest of Eorn, whose recent actions have led to the death of a knight of the Crucible. It requests reporting any information to Justiciar Aldmar. It is signed Commander Cleaver. Huh. Eorn. I don't know, should we know who that is? Apparently, Eorn has looted capture thus far, though the knights continue to hunt for him. It seems unlikely he could get past the guards at the gates. I should look for him in the city. Hopefully he's not in Copper Lane. I'm kind of done there for now. This is a record of active patrols and reported crimes in Andra's Gift. The latter far outnumber the former. Reported... crimes are far more greater than the patrols.
A simple test.
I'll leave that. Just happy he's getting all this experience, actually. The Blacksmith Knights. A short history of the Knights of the Crucible. Cool. If the blacksmith fails, the armor fails. If the armor fails, the soldier fails. Alren Siniad, first guildmaster of the Knights of the Crucible. The Knights of the Crucible have one of the most fascinating and rich histories in all of Eora. Currently holding a position as an incredibly influential group in the Deerwood, they come from humble beginnings. There may not be a single person in all the Deerwood who knows exactly how much they owe to the Knights. The group has existed for years, long before they even came to be known as knights. They started as a group of blacksmiths, led by Alren Siniad, who came together to form a guild. Alren felt it imperative to the members, for the members to unify, sharing their knowledge through the guild in order to keep the skills and techniques they had spent their lives perfecting. He called the guild the Crucible, insisting that, though their work was used for destruction, they should always be remembered as creators. They would be known as the vessel that withstands the fire to deliver new form into the world, forged in the fire and all the stronger for the tribulation. Alren, being a veteran of many battles, knew the importance of impeccably made armor and weaponry. He also espoused the necessity for members of the guild to be trained in martial combat. The only true way to make a proper suit of armor is to be the one who must wear it. Alrun led the guild for many years, instituting a policy that any man who wanted to join must not only be a skilled blacksmith, but also take the time to learn how to hold himself in battle. He added a training ground to their guild hall, and there was scarcely a minute of daylight that didn't see members out on the field honing their fighting technique. Because of this, the guild earned the nickname Knights of the Crucible. They became a de facto militia for the Deerwood, an honorable group that many turned to for help. They were known to be fair, ethical, and quick to respond. The knights chose Abaddon as their patron, dedicating their works to his name. To honor him, they incorporated his symbol into their own, and wrote it on their arms. Many of the knights took this honor further. Regardless of what material a suit of armor was made from, something on the right arm was made with iron, celebrating Abaddon's moniker, the Iron Arm. Both of these traditions are followed by some of the knights to this day. The knights' smithing skill led them to be known throughout the land as the premier artisans of their craft, leading people to call any item of exquisite quality of the Crucible. Their training and dedication truly came into play during the War of Defiance, locally known as Hadrett's Rebellion. Alrun, knowing the importance of winning this war, sent out a call. All able-bodied knights were to join the militia. They quickly proved invaluable to the cause and helped turn the tide of the rebellion. This was particularly true in the Battle of Defiance Bay. Admeth had already been lost in a previous battle, and morale for the Deerwooden militia was failing. With the help of Glanfathan astrologers. Why does it look funny to me? I don't know. The knights were able to rout the imperial forces and secure victory for the Deerwood. The new duke, grateful for the help and knowing that without the knights, the Deerwood never would have survived, made a decree. The knights would thenceforth be welcomed into the duke's castle and become his official royal guard. In recent years, the crucible aspect has fallen by the wayside in favor of knight. The requirement that the members be proficient in both smithing and martial combat has loosened to the point that anyone who applies is guaranteed entrance, even if they possess little or no smithing experience. This is an allegation that is vehemently denied by the knights. Surprised they didn't ban that book. Penhelm's affidavit. Curran, a cipher duly appointed and employed by Dunreed Rowe, does hereby certify that novitiate A. M. Penhelm has been found to have a soul free of any subversive influences of tainted essence. The scroll is stamped with the seal of Dunreed Rowe and signed by both Penhelm and Curran. This was signed by two people. Bring Penhelm's affidavit to Curran. Curran works at Hadrett House in Brackenbury. Okay. So I have to go elsewhere to finish this quest. He should know for certain whether or not the affidavit is genuine. Okay. So we're not finishing that this episode.